In this video I will show how my game went from this simple looking prototype to this much better looking game. Hi, I am Jacob and I am making an incremental game about moose mining gems in Z with Raylib. The moose are mining and selling gems and you decide on how to spend the earnings. Hire more miners or upgrade them or upgrade the mine infrastructure. The idea of the game came from these fake ads for a mobile game. The actual game played nothing like the ads they show, so I thought, if they are not going to make that game, I might as well make something like it. I started with the idea and first prototype back in February. At that time, I was busy working on the full release of Sidestep Legends, but I could not keep away from taking a few days to build a prototype for this game, so I did. This is what it looked like back then. Just a very simple prototype to test the concept and to get an idea of how difficult it would be to build. Fast forward to May, when Sidestep Legends had been fully released and gotten a couple of updates after as well. It was now time to start this new project for real. The most important thing with the game is of course that it is fun to play. So the first focus would be to make the prototype fun. So far, the prototype had mostly been about trying out the concept on a very basic design level and to lay down the technical foundation. But now I needed to nail the actual game loop of the game. The biggest problem with the current prototype was that it was hard to keep the income increasing as you progressed deeper into the mine, even if the rocks increased in value. The cost was that the miners had to walk further to deliver the gems to the grinder the deeper they mine. The solution? Minecarts. So now you could build rails and minecarts to keep the travel distance for the miners short. It also comes with the added bonus of having another thing that can become the bottleneck of your operation. Then I added storage points and another railway with minecarts in the base that is responsible for picking up the processed gems and selling them, adding yet another thing that can become a bottleneck. Now the player must have a proper look around their operation to find what is most worth upgrading next. Should I upgrade the mining speed of the miners, hire a new miner, or add more minecarts to transfer more gems per trip to the grinders? Next it was time for someone other than me to try the game, so I asked my wife to playtest it. She helped me out with the UI graphics and design for my games, and usually is the first one to playtest them. She was not very excited to test it at first, because she thought it would not be fun, but she tried the game anyway. After getting through the first 50 minutes of the game, which was a bit slow, she really liked it and did not want to stop playing. She had made plans to meet up with some friends that day and almost ended up being late for it due to playing the game for a bit too long. So with that success, I reduced the time to get things going at the start of the game to make sure people will get to the good part quick enough, and now it felt like I really got something good here. With the gameplay pretty much done, it was time to pick a theme and visual look for the game. When I started planning the project, I had thought of having the miners be dwarfs. That would fit the mining theme well, since dwarfs are typical miners in a fantasy setting. I also already had dwarf models from the Cinder packs I bought for Sidestep Legends, so it would be cost efficient as well. They would mine with large saw blades that they would carry, since saw blades were also included in the packs I had bought, and would also be quite light on animations. Important things when you are mostly working solo on a project. However, now when I started thinking more about themes for the game, I thought that it would be much more fun and interesting if the miners were some kind of animals. Dwarves would fit the theme well, but they are quite generic in this context, so an animal would stand out more. I also happened to have an asset pack of forest animals laying around, so why not pick something from there? It included a moose, which would fit really well. It is a typical Swedish animal, so it had the benefit of having a connection to my country as well. Also, there are very few games that feature moose as their main characters, which is an added bonus. And if you think of it, moose are quite perfectly built to mine and transport with their large, strong bodies. At least in the mine in this game, where all the gems are conveniently placed in a grid on a pretty much flat ground. The forest animal pack with the moose was made in a realistic style, and since I still wanted to use the Synth assets for all other things, that would not work well together. Luckily, it is easy enough to lower the amount of polygons in the model, and these models also already came with low poly LODs. So I just replaced the realistic texture with the color texture that is used for the other assets, and manually selected the colors for the different vertices. And we go from this to this, which fits perfectly with the Synth assets. After that, there was some more work on the game figuring out different UI for selecting what to upgrade, as well as adding the actual UI, and then we're pretty much up to date with where the game is today. If you think the game looks interesting, head over to Steam and add it to your wishlist. It really helps me out a lot. I'll leave a link to it below. I am planning to do some more technical devlogs about different parts of the game, how it works and how I made it, as well as how I used and customized Raylib for it. So if there is any particular part of the development you are interested in more detail, please write a comment about it and I will take that into account while planning the upcoming devlogs. I'll shortly present a few ideas I have for future devlogs. If any of those sound interesting to you, please tell me in the comments so I know which one I should prioritize. The first one is about how I implemented GPU bone animations with Raylib for this game. The second is about how I handle the big world of the game. It is about 32,000 rocks wide and up to 2 billion rocks deep, even if you would never be practically able to mine so deep with the current design of the game. The third topic is about how I profile the game to see what parts need optimization whenever the performance is not as good as it needs to be. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe for more. Bye!